After it made an explosive appearance in our recent video, some of you have asked for the recipe to my homemade ginger beer. Today I'm going to show you how to make it. It does not require any sophisticated equipment and only involves a few ingredients, so you can make this yourself at home. It is a very simple and rewarding process. I hope you give it a try. We are going to establish a naturally fermenting ginger beer bug. We feed it daily and end up in a cycle where every week we're then using it to bottle up a constant supply of authentic and old-fashioned ginger beer. I make it all summer and well into the autumn. It's super refreshing on a hot day. The first thing we have to do is get our bug established, and we only ever need to do this once, so I'm going to call it day zero. In a clean glass jar, add 2 cups of water. To the water we then add a few raisins and 2 teaspoons of sugar and give it a stir. Most recipes will tell you to cover with muslin cloth or similar, but I had a terrible time with fruit flies filling my kitchen, so have been using these burping lids instead, and that's worked out great for me. Sit it up on a shelf, out of direct sunlight, at room temperature. This is the beginning of our fermentation. 24 hours later, day 1, we open it up and feed it another 2 teaspoons of sugar. And this time we also add 2 teaspoons of ground ginger. If you wanted, you could use fresh ginger, and I'm sure you can find plenty of recipes here on YouTube that use fresh ginger juice. But because we're adding ginger every other day, I find it really convenient just to use ground ginger. Stir it all together, then back up on the shelf it goes. Day 2, we only feed it 2 teaspoons of sugar, no ginger. Then from here, we just keep alternating between feeding it sugar and ginger, or only sugar each day, until we reach day 7. The method is all in the description below, but just quickly, this makes day 3 feeding 2 teaspoons of sugar and 2 teaspoons of ginger again. Day 4 is back to just 2 teaspoons of sugar. Day 5 is both sugar and ginger again. Day 6, back to only sugar. And then finally, we've made it to day 7. Now, if this is the very first day 7, the bug will have started to be active, but it's not going to be strong enough yet. So we actually skip bottling this first week and instead drain off and discard the liquid. Save half the sediment and discard the other half.
This looks gross.
Then to the saved sediment, we add another 2 cups of water, another 2 teaspoons of sugar. Stir it all back up and then repeat days 1 through 6. But from the second day 7 on, we're at the exciting bit. We've built up a good thick layer of sediment, our bug is actively bubbling away, and we're ready to bottle. Add 2 cups of sugar to a large clean pot and stir in 2 cups of boiling water. If you're starting to get a little worried about how much sugar is in this, do keep in mind that our ginger beer bug is actually eating most of it as it fuels the fermentation process. Once dissolved, add 12 cups of cool water and then stir in the strained juice of 2 lemons. Finally, strain your fermented ginger bug liquid into the mix, capturing the sediment, and give it all another good stir.
Just put like that to that's to carry on.
Wash your bottles in really hot soapy water and rinse them out well. I like using swing top glass bottles, which I think are really great because you can use them again and again. And if the seals get worn, you can just replace the seal. These swing top lids are pretty good with pressure, and they do make it easy to relieve a bit of fizz every now and then if you think you have a particularly potent brew. I'm not a very big fan of using plastic, but a lot of people do recommend you bottle into old soft drink bottles, because a plastic bottle is going to be safer with the pressure and you eliminate the possibility of any exploding glass. So maybe that is a good idea, especially when you're first starting out and getting familiar with the process. Once your bottles are washed, rinsed, and ready to go, you can add a few raisins to each bottle for a bit of extra flavour if you like. And then you just fill each bottle up to near the top with the ginger beer and seal. We now restart our bug, combining approximately half the sediment with another 2 cups of water and another 2 teaspoons of sugar. And tomorrow, day one, then begins again, and the cycle repeats. The other half of the sediment is going to be discarded, so you could give it away to a friend to let them start their own ginger beer production, or keep it and have 2 bugs on the go for double the weekly amount of ginger beer. Store your freshly bottled ginger beer somewhere safe at room temperature and leave it to ferment for a further week. You don't need to feed it anymore, and then at the end of that week, this batch of bottles is now finally ready to be cooled in the fridge and enjoyed. You can tweak the amount of ginger you are adding to suit your taste, and the longer you leave your ginger beer in the fridge before drinking it, the drier and less sweet it will become, as the bug continues to consume the sugar.
The fermented! I don't see them on the glass.
Some people will suggest that you should be regularly relieving pressure in the bottles over that week of final fermentation.
Oh, it's game on me. It's game on me. Oh, it's game on me.
What's game on you,
Leah? The fermented.
Do they bite?
No. They're not biting me. Mom. They're just looking at me.
If you ever want to just pause production for a while, I've put my ginger beer bug in the refrigerator for up to a week at a time without feeding it, and it's been fine. I've then just taken it out and kept going without problems.
Looking cool. Yeah, I think it's awesome. You guys have been busy.
Mum, you're going to be my room. Like,
fermented foods, including this type of wild brewed ginger beer, are naturally rich in probiotics. These are the same microorganisms in our gut that help to support metabolic and digestive health, as well as play an important role in the immune system. Ginger, too, has medicinal properties of its own. I've heard of people substituting the ginger for turmeric to make turmeric beer, and I might give that a go next summer.
It's kind of a bluey colour.
Is it going to bite me?
It's a baby giant centipede, I think.
Hey, Judah.
Can we have some ginger beer? Very fizzy.
As you can see, I don't have any issues with getting lots of fizz. There must be a lot of different factors that go into how fizzy the end result is. The strength of your individual bug, the amount and type of sugar being added, how well sealed the bottles are, even fluctuations in the weather. Just please don't go blowing anything up. And perhaps most important of all, the children love it.
It's very fizzy.
Fermenting is a lot of fun, and I get a lot of satisfaction out of the process. The daily routine of feeding is almost therapeutic, and I often have a few ferments on the go all at once. This ginger beer, and also kefir, sauerkraut, mustard, and sourdough. Bum, 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 bum.